This video is going to walk you through the steps needed to create a headline image using Pixlr.com. So you're going to need to go to Pixlr.com. The hardest part is that there's no E in Pixlr, P-I-X-L-R.com. Once you're here, you're going to choose the advanced Pixlr editor. And then prior to this, I had saved the headline template and a couple of pictures into a folder, so I'm going to go ahead and open that template from that folder. So I hit open image from computer. I've got them here. Wherever you have them saved, you're going to browse there. I open the headline template, and as it's coming in, you're going to notice over on the right there's a palette over here that's called the layers palette. I personally don't use the history palette very much, but I do use the layers palette, so I'm going to open that a little bit more. And you'll notice that one of the layers, the bottom layer of this document, came in locked. You see a padlock. So I need to unlock it, and all I did was double-clicked to unlock it. So a personal preference of mine is to open this up all the way so I can see it, but that's up to you. So the first thing we're going to do is bring in the picture that we're going to use as the background. So I can go to Layer and Open Image as Layer. Remember, I already have this picture here. This could be a picture I got off the internet. Of course, think about copyright problems. It could be a picture I took with my camera or someone sent me. I'm going to go ahead and open it. And when it comes in, it's going to go sitting right on top of whatever layer I had selected. So you see it's sitting right on top of the title bar. That's not where I want it. I need to click and drag it underneath the title bar. If we had not unlocked that little padlock, it wouldn't let you do that, but you could always unlock it now. So the next thing I need to do is change to my Move tool over in my Tools palette, and now I can click, because I've highlighted this layer, I can click and I can drag the picture around to get it to look right. I want you to notice right now, this picture does not fit in this space. You always have to have a picture or a background that fits that space. So I need to make this picture a little bit larger. To do that, I need to go to the Edit menu and choose Free Transform, and that's going to show me those little dots. Now a trick here to resize is to hold my Shift key down on the keyboard and resize from the corner, and that's going to keep the proportions right. And I can still move it around if I want to. So I'll say that that's about right. I could add additional information if I wanted to, but so you have to think about how you want your picture to appear first. If you're going to add text, make sure it's centered in a way you can do that. To apply this transition that we just, or this transformation that we just did, just click off of it, and then you're going to be asked, do you want to apply it? And yes. So we've got this so far. The next thing we need to do is put in actual text there instead of headline text. Pixlr does not let you edit the text, so what you're going to need to do is create a new text layer on top of that and then turn off the one that says headline text. So I click on the text tool over in my tools, click anywhere in here, and a little window pops up like this, so I'm going to write Camp Jolt Information. The trickiest part of this, believe it or not, is picking Times New Roman. It's kind of weird, and plus I have a bazillion fonts, I realize, but you have to really, oh, there it is. Sometimes it's tricky. You have to get it in there just exactly right with the arrows. So I choose Times New Roman. 30 is okay for a size in this, 28, 29, 30, something like that. I leave it on regular, and I need to change the color. This is a different color wheel here. This is the black. We need to go all the way up to the corner and make sure we choose white and OK, and then we tell it OK. Now I'm going to get my Move tool again from my tools, and I'm going to click on that and drag it over, right over the headline one, so I know it's in the right place. I come over to my layers palette and I uncheck the headline text, and I have my image. So the last thing I need to do is save it. File, save. I'm going to rename it here, change it to be the highest quality, and then OK. I will save it. I'm going to actually change the name here because I forgot I had that. Hit save, and then it's working, and then you're going to be able to put it on your site.